This video looks into collision theory and how it affects chemical reactions. Collision theory is about the particles involved in a chemical reaction. For a reaction to happen, the reacting particles must collide successfully. A successful collision depends on the amount of energy particles have. The particles may not have enough energy, so they move slowly, touch but don't react. Or the particles may have too much energy and essentially bounce off each other unreacted. Particles must also be in an appropriate position to react. A successful collision is dependent on the energy of the particles as well as the position of the particles. This second point is often overlooked. Temperature affects the number of collisions and the rate of a chemical reaction. Increasing the temperature increases the kinetic energy of the particles, which means they move faster. This means that the frequency of successful collisions increases, or the particles collide more often. When talking about temperature, a successful collision is one where the particles have more energy than the required activation energy. This idea of energy and activation energy is a key point for how temperature affects the number of collisions and rate of reaction. You also have to be able to explain how decreasing the temperature affects the number of collisions and rate of reaction. This question provides some guidance towards the answer, but not all questions will be like this. For these types of questions, you should talk about energy. Increasing the temperature means that the particles have more kinetic energy. Then, you should talk about the movement of the particles. So, the particles move faster. These two points gain the first mark. Next, talk about how often the particles collide. So, the particles collide more frequently. For the second mark. Finally, talk about activation energy. This means that more particles have energy above the activation energy. For the third mark. You can also be asked about if the temperature decreases and the effect it has on the rate of reaction. Essentially, your answer will be the opposite of what's written. In any chemical reaction, increasing the number of collisions and successful collisions will increase the rate of reaction. The second factor that can affect the rate of reaction is pressure. Increasing the pressure means that there are the same number of particles in a smaller space, as shown. This leads to more frequent successful collisions. The third factor is concentration. Increasing the concentration means that there are more particles in the same space. This again leads to more frequent successful collisions. The fourth factor that affects the rate of reaction is surface area. Increasing the surface area means that there are more particles available to react, as shown. This again leads to more frequent successful collisions. The final factor that affects the rate of a reaction is the presence of a catalyst. This works by providing an alternative route for the reaction that has a lower activation energy. Apart from catalysts, your answers should always talk about the frequency of collisions. In parts 1 and 2, your answer should cover the rate of reaction, the particles, and the frequency of collisions. So, let's apply this. Part 1 is about increasing pressure. This will increase the rate of reaction for 1 mark. This is because there are more particles in a smaller volume for the second mark. And this leads to more frequent successful collisions for the third mark. Part 2 is about decreasing concentration. This means that the rate of reaction will decrease for 1 mark. This is because there are less particles in the same amount of space for the second mark. Therefore, this causes less frequent successful collisions for the third mark. Part 3 is about adding a catalyst, which requires a slightly different approach. To start with, you should state how the catalyst affects the rate of reaction. A catalyst increases the rate of reaction for 1 mark. Then you should talk about the reaction pathway. So, a catalyst provides an alternative reaction pathway or route for the second mark. Finally, you should talk about activation energy. So, the alternative pathway requires a lower activation energy for the final mark. Remember that pressure, concentration, and surface area should all talk about the frequency of collisions. In summary, The rate of a chemical reaction depends on the energy and orientation of the particles as they collide. Increasing the temperature gives the particles more kinetic energy, so they move faster, leading to more collisions with energy greater than the activation energy and an increased rate of reaction. Increasing the pressure means that there are the same number of particles in a smaller volume. Increasing the concentration means that there are more particles in the same volume. Increasing the surface area means that there are more particles available to react. All of these lead to more frequent successful collisions and an increased rate of reaction. Finally, a catalyst increases the rate of a chemical reaction by providing an alternative reaction pathway of lower activation energy. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.